Ladies and gentlemen, with the release of Minecraft version 1.18.2, a number of new technical features have been introduced, including general tag support and a new command. My name is SliceLime, and in this video I'll be going through all the technical news with one exception. The custom world data format changes are going to be in a separate video. Let's dive in! To begin with, the current datapack version is now 9. In order to have a datapack not flagged as out of date, you'll need to update the pack.mc meta file. In command news, let's start with that new command. It's called placefeature, and it takes a resource location, or namespaced ID argument, to a configured feature that it will then place. You can also specify the location to place the feature at, and if you don't, it will act as if you had specified tilde, tilde, tilde. The configured features mentioned here are things you'll be familiar with if you've worked with custom world generation before, but basically they include all the smaller things in the game that spawn on top of or inside terrain, including trees, flower patches, ores, and so on. Moving on to other command changes, the locate command now has a different type of parameter. Instead of a built-in structure name, it now wants the namespaced ID of a configured structure type. These are in some cases the same, but in other cases more precise. For instance, instead of locating a village, you'll now be locating a village underscore plains in specific. If you still want to locate any village, you can use another new piece of functionality, where the locate and locate biome commands both now support tags as an argument. So to locate any type of village, you now instead use locate hash village. Configured structure tags are available for all cases where more than one configured structure exists per built-in structure type. So to upgrade a previously existing command, you'll simply need to add a hash sign. Let me also mention a notable bug fix for the spread players command, which now works with negative heights for the under parameter. There are lots of changes in this version that relate to the brand new tags system. Before we get into that, let me ask you to please take a moment to give the like button a brand new tag as well. That helps get YouTube to share the video to more viewers, so I'd really appreciate it. Thank you. So what is this new tag system, and how is it different from the tags you could already define? Well, previously, you could create tags for certain select features in the game. This has been expanded so you can now create tags for everything that the game has in a so-called registry. If you don't know which registries exist or what they contain, you can look at the registries.json file that the built-in data generator can produce. I'll leave a command line in the video description that you can use. That list contains all the registries in the game with built-in types. In addition to this, all custom world generation definition types are also registries. This means you can now make tags for everything from blocks and items to biomes, tree decorator types, or villager professions. Of course, being able to make these tags doesn't necessarily mean that you can actually use them for anything useful, but this opens up for further interesting developments in the future, and there are several places where they are already used in this version. Tags for types that already supported tags are still defined in the same place, but all other types follow a new pattern. That pattern is data slash your namespace slash tags slash and the registry name. In practice, this means the tag name is in singular rather than plural. Let's begin with biomes. Biome tags are now being used by the game. You can find them under the tags slash worldgen slash biome folder. There are built-in biome tags for groups of biomes like is underscore badlands and is underscore mountain. There are also tags for every type of configured structure in the game found under the has underscore structure subfolder. Adding a biome to one of these tags makes the game able to generate that structure type in that biome. There are also new tags for configured structures. These include the ones needed for being able to easily upgrade locate commands, that is, mineshafts, ocean ruins, ruined portals, shipwrecks, and villages. But there are also ones that control some aspect of gameplay. Let's start with dolphin located, controlling which types of structures a dolphin can locate when fed fish. Eye of Ender located is similar. It controls what type of structure an eye will travel towards when thrown. There are also three tags related to maps: on treasure maps, on ocean explorer maps, and on woodland explorer maps, controlling which types of structures that type of map can point to. And let's wrap up our tag rundown with a new block tag. Fall damage resetting. This contains all the blocks that the game considers to reset your fall damage when you fall through them, which by default is anything climbable, sweet berry bushes, and cobwebs. A predicate change. The feature field in location predicates now also reference configured structures rather than built-in structure types. And for loot tables, the same thing applies to the destination field of an exploration map loot table function. And the exploration map function also no longer automatically sets the name of the item, so you'll need to do that with a separate set name function instead. Let's also mention a notable bug fix for structure blocks. They now rotate entities correctly when loading a structure with a rotation, although it seems like there are some lingering problems with mirroring still. In resource pack news, a new file has been added. It's called regional_compliancies.json and contains information about the hourly pop-ups that display in South Korea. The top level of the file is a map of locales to lists of events. The events contain translation strings to be shown, which are passed an argument consisting of the number of times the message has been shown. If you're also tinkering with vanilla shaders, I'll quickly note that the fog calculations have changed once again. If you want to know the details, check out fog.glsl. In server news, the server.properties file generated by the game now contains some settings that were previously missing, including level seed, level type, generator settings, and generate structures. Let's end with a quick look at some changes that affect modders. Of course, the fairly extensive changes to registries and the world generation types with the new custom world functionality is likely to clash with some mod code. In addition, logging functionality now resides in a new library called com.mojang.logging. And finally, an error with how the game determined the distance between two blocks has been fixed, which should fix a number of issues, including ones in mods using that piece of code. That's all for me for this time. Thanks for sticking around for the full video, I really appreciate it. If you're interested in more news about what's changing lately, also check out this video.